The neat thing about the partnerships here in South Texas is the fact that we are involving the local hospitals, the EMS, the police department, the high schools, everybody that wants to come and use our resources. We are here for them, and we're really excited to be able to offer that to the Valley. So what we have here at the hospital are different rooms that are specific to different types of patient care. For example, we have the daily living room where we learn how to take care of rehab patients. In the clinical skills room is where it would be called a medical surgical floor, where we take care of the medical surgical type patient that is not someone that's seriously injured. Then we go down to the emergency room, and we have an emergency room there for people who are coming in just like a regular emergency room, and we take care of the patients there. We have a trauma room where we have an OR bed, and they come in and take care of a traumatic injury such as a motor vehicle accident. Then we would take the patients over to the ICU after they're done in the trauma.
Please, give me something for this pain. It hurts. It really hurts.
From there, we also have pediatric and adolescent capabilities in our pediatric ICU. And then we have the birthing room where we have a manikin that gives birth. And then we have an area which is our postpartum, where the mother and the baby go after the birthing. We have three reflection rooms where we can go in after we've video recorded in each room, because each room has a video capability over their beds to record the scenarios that are going on. And then the faculty would then take the learners over into those rooms and run the video back and talk about what went right, what went wrong. And then that helps the student frame a better outcome of the next time they're in the scenario.
The manikins we are using, and indeed all of the technology we're using, is the most advanced technology in the world. And one of the driving forces of this is the U.S. military. The U.S. military uses this kind of technology for training. And for example, it allows us to set up a scenario where we could simulate an automobile accident, and we can actually follow the EMS people as they go to the accident, what they do with the manikin at the accident, all the way to the hospital. And we can do that and project it across our entire network.
Well, we've been very pleased that we were included from the ground floor on this partnership, because from the very beginning, it was made clear to us that we were an integral part of medical education in our valley and in our region. The simulation manikins are a great resource for us because they provide a bridge between books and actual patients.
And it's really crucial that you learn all you can from the manikins, because when you go out to actual clinical rotations, everything you do can affect the real human. You know, it's no longer a simulation, but it's an actual person.
And it's really helpful because it'll teach us in not just the medical field but in life itself to kind of learn things quickly, be able to understand just a little bit more easily, you know, so that it kind of just clicks a little bit better.
So having this resource here in the Valley and in Harlingen is going to be an excellent opportunity for them to come during the school day, experience what the different areas of the hospital are like without actually having to be in the hospital setting.
So it gives a lot of hands-on experience to our nurses and EMS providers and students as well. Well,
through our accreditation, we're currently accredited, and that's one of the requirements they do ask from us, is actually do not only actual patient training like in the hospital and doing rotations through the hospital, but they also ask that we do simulation training through preset scenarios.
I think the simulation hospital is an essential tool for the new medical school, because as you know, the educational curriculum is changing for the medical school, and there are a lot of competencies that actually need to be met. Many of these competencies may not be met in the clinical arena.